Hello children, today in EVS 1 for Standard 4, we are going to learn lesson number 19, My Delightful School. Now observe the pictures given. Here we can see that it is a science lab and the children are doing experiments together. In the next picture, we can see that it is a library and children are reading books. This is a picture of a classroom where teacher is explaining and teaching them about the world map. This picture we can see over here is that the children are doing painting. Here the children are playing together. So in all these pictures, we can see that how children are learning together happily. Why do we go to school? We go to school to learn. We make many friends in school. We study with each other's help. We play together and share our tiffins. We take part in school functions and go on trips together. We come together to clean and decorate the classroom. There are so many things which we do together. It is great fun to do so. What can we do to make sure that every child in the class finds it is fun to learn? Now children, do you know? An example is given to us. I got a letter. This is the story of a school in Kolavali in Ratnagiri district. This is the map of Ratnagiri. The teacher took his students to the post office to show them how the postal system works. He explained its working to the students, but to give them a first-hand experience of how it works, he used a novel idea. He wrote a letter to every child, telling them about their progress in studies, in sports, their interests and activities. The children were thrilled to see the letters. They showed their letter to everyone, saying, "I got a letter." Some even sent a reply to the letter. They sent greeting cards to the teacher at the time of Diwali. A few days later, the teacher taught the students how to send emails. One letter sent by the teacher awakened a new enthusiasm in the students. The school became an enjoyable place for them. So children, it is very important when you do things practically, when you see it and do it, that time you learn it in a better way. So same thing the teacher did over here. She took them to a post office and she explained the working of it. And the children understood it in a better way. Cooperation. Now children, have a three-legged race with other students in your class. Why could some pairs reach the finish line without stumbling or falling? And why did some pairs fall while running? If we help each other, we can succeed at anything. Work becomes enjoyable. In order to help one another, we must first understand our mutual needs and difficulties. Do we try to understand the needs of our classmates? There may be a new student in class or a student who lives far away from their parents. There may be someone who speaks a different language at home. Some may have an older brother or sister to help them and some may not. Because of this diversity, everyone has different needs. We must try to understand these needs. In school, we meet different kinds of students. There are a few people who cannot see, and a few who cannot hear. A few cannot walk easily. The needs of students such as these are different and special. We can understand them only by getting to know them well. So, children with special needs. Now we shall learn about the children with special needs. Every child should get the joy of learning in school. All children with special needs have the right to education. Many parents of children with special needs send their children to school with great determination. The government also has many schemes for them. If you know any children with special needs, do tell the teachers and parents about this. They too will encourage the children to go to school. Education of girls. The government has also provided many facilities for the education of girls. Most parents try to make sure that the girls are educated. Sometimes girls are expected to carry out household chores such as taking care of their siblings, drawing water from the well, etc. all by themselves. As a result, they lag behind in school or even leave it. They are also known as dropouts. A girl's education should not stop for this or for any other reason. Girls too have a right to the joy of learning. Now we shall learn about mother tongue. Even if we learn in a common language at school, we all speak in our mother tongue at home. The mother tongue of some students may be Gujarati. Some may speak Hindi at home, while others may speak Telugu or Kannada. Because of school, we get friends who speak different languages. Respect for diversity. We all wear a uniform in school. However, on days when the uniform is not compulsory, the classroom becomes colorful. It is fun to attend a class where there is a lot of diversity. Our customs, languages, and eating habits may be different, but as human beings, we are all alike. When we respect this diversity and help each other, we enjoy being in school. School becomes delightful. Now children, what's the solution for this? Pintu and Pinky have both got admission into kindergarten. Every day when the school bus comes to take them to school, they cry and cry. How will you explain to them why they must go to school? So how will you convince these two children that not to cry and they have to go to school? So you can tell them that other children also go to school. they will make many new friends over there and they can play games with them. So this way we can convince them and we can send them to school. So children, what have we learned? We get many different friends in school. In school, we come to know about the diversity in our country. Every child must get the joy of learning in school. All children, including those with special needs, have the right to education. When we offer and seek help, learning becomes more enjoyable. I hope so you've understood the lesson and enjoyed watching the video. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe my channel and stay tuned for more videos. Bye-bye.